Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Onmai. Now this video is regarding how to add audio to PowerPoint presentations. Many of us actually started giving away the video lectures or the video material to the students because of this lockdown condition. Now some of us have actually learned how to do the screen capturing in the ICT course that we have done, and many of us started the using a software called as Screenomatic, or we can use even the other softwares like we have something called as EZVid, and there are many other screen capturing softwares like that. And of course many of us are using the free versions of these softwares. Now when you use these screen capturing softwares, and specifically I'm talking about the free versions, these softwares don't give you the capability of editing what you have recorded. So what happens is, if you start recording and let's say you make some mistake in between, then you have to record the video with those mistakes. So there is no editing option available over there. And sometimes when you put such things on the web and you have made some mistakes over there, it actually gives a kind of a bad impression. So that is one issue what I felt. And the second issue what we have is the time limit. The Screenomatic like software allows you to record only for 15 minutes. So if you don't fit in your content, then you will have to start with the next video. That means whatever presentations you have, you will have to break it in the chunks. And then one will have to record them carefully and again try to avoid the mistakes. Okay, also one has to be very careful because it is a 15 minutes time slot for which you will have to speak continuously without any pauses. Of course there is a pause option available, but many of you us normally don't feel that way. So what I found is, instead of using a Screenomatic, if you have just a presentation which you want to share with the student, and to that presentation you want to add a noise, a voice. So in such cases, one can easily use the capability that is provided in the Microsoft PowerPoint itself. So I will demonstrate that with a small example over here. So I will quickly give you a demo how to add the voice to the PPT, and then how to play it or how to make a video out of it. So first you need to open a presentation to which you want to add a audio. So this is a small presentation what I have with the four slides. Okay, so what you need to do is, normally there is a top menu bar what we have. So the first button over there is File, then we have Home, and third one is Insert. So go to the Insert. So it will open up your Insert menu on the top. And now if you go to the end of that menu bar, then you will find that there are three options. One is video, audio, and screen recording. So video will allow you to insert the video in your presentation, audio will allow you to insert audio, and screen recording will allow you to record the screen and add it over here. So you will go for audio. Now here there will be two options available to you. The first option is audio on my PC. And second option is record audio. So audio on my PC is the option available where you already stored something on your PC, and that audio you want to add to your slides. Okay. In this case, we are going to record the audio. So we will press the record button over here. So when you press that record audio button, a screen will appear something like this at the center. Normally, I like to keep this screen slightly aside so that I can see the content of my slides. So move it a bit. And after that, you can see there are three buttons over here. There is a one red button, so that when you press that red button, it will start recording your audio, and you have to press it again to stop the recording. So let's start recording. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Onmai, and I'm giving a demo over here how to add audio to the PPT. So once you are done this, press OK button over here. So this will stop the recording, and you can see there is a speaker kind of icon that has appeared over here at the center of your PowerPoint slide. Now if you just click on it, then it will open a bar over here where you can listen to what you are recording. So this is over here. Now I have listened. Okay, I am satisfied with that audio. So I'm going to keep it. So what I will do is, normally I prefer it to keep it at one of the corners so that this icon doesn't hide or it doesn't overlap with the content of your slide. So keep it in some corner. Normally I keep it in right top corner. So let it be over there. So this is my first slide done. Now I will go to the second slide. I will do the same process. I will go to the audio, record audio. I will start the recording. Before that, I just move this recorder slightly outside so that I can see the content. Okay, so I will record. Like this particular method has many advantages. Like, it is a simple process. We can edit it if the recording is on. no time limit, etc., etc. Okay. Now I stopped it, but somehow there was a issue. There was some noise, or you can see I coughed when I was recording it. So I'm not, when I played, I hear some background noise. So what I will do is, I will simply delete this and I will record it again. So record again, whatever you want. So I'm recording. I will say okay. I will listen to it. I'm happy. I will keep it. So this is one flexibility this method will allow you, which is not available in Screencast-O-Matic. Okay, there one has to go with the errors, or one has to be very careful to avoid any such errors or some background noises, etc. Okay, so this is done. Similarly, I can add audio to this next slide. So I start the recording. So I'm recording. And let's say I forgot to press OK button and it kept on recording. So there is some blank portions at the end. So what I will do is, I will right click on this speaker like icon. So now over here it will give you three options at the top. One is trim, style, and new comment. So if I go for trim, this will allow you to trim your audio from the start or from the end. So if you want something unnecessary which is at the start, you can trim it off from here, or there is something unnecessary at the end, you can trim it off from the end like this. Okay, remember, it allows you to only trim it from the start and end. It doesn't allow you to cut anything from the middle. Okay, so let's say I trim the audio like this. Okay, similarly, I add the audio to my next slide. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm happy with the audio, so I keep it over here. Now, if you play this video, okay, let me start from the first slide. Okay, I will have to press the down arrow key or the space button every time to start the audio. Okay, so this is going to happen because right now my presentation is in a manual transition mode. So what you need to do, once you're done your recording, okay, you have to convert your entire presentation in auto transition mode. So what you're going to do is, select all the slides. So click on any of the slides and say Control A. So when you do that, all the slides, you can see it over here, all the slides over here are now being selected. And now from the menu bar, I will go to transition. So when you go to the transition, again, if you look at the right corner over here, You can see the advanced slide option, and over here you can see that by default that advanced slide option has a tick mark on mouse click. That means you will have to mouse click or press the space bar or the down arrow key to move it further. Okay, so what you are going to do is untick it, and there is an option after, and there is a time over there, 0000000. You are going to click this. Okay, so one has to be, see over here, one has to untick on mouse click, and one has to keep it tick after and time. Okay, so you can add a delay if you want, but normally I don't prefer adding any delay over here, so I will keep it 0000000. Okay, so when you have done this, this will be applicable to all your slides. And then when you play your presentation, your slides will move automatically. So now I'm not pressing anything. Okay, and you can see that the slides will automatically go ahead with the audio played. Actually, for each slide you added some audio. So it will play that audio. Once that audio is finished, it will go to the next slide. Okay, so now my my presentation is ready with the audio and in auto run mode. So if you want, you can share the presentation like this, which has the audio to it, but I don't prefer like this. The reason is anyone can change the content, anyone can remove the audio. So what I will do is, once I've finished everything, first I will save this. So now my audios are also saved with my PowerPoint presentation. So every time when you open, those audios will be there. And now I will go to my, again, the menu bar at the top. I have an option of file. And in that there is option save as. You can give the name that you want for your file and the type. Okay, by default it is the PowerPoint presentation.pptx. Okay, so if you click on that, it will open up a menu bar over there. And if you go down, you can see an option as MP4. So when you click on this, whatever is your PowerPoint presentation, it will be converted to a video of MP4 format. So I will say save. So here you can see in the bar, there is a progress of conversion it is showing. Okay, so it says creating video of something something, and it is showing you the progress of that. So once finished, that video will be available. Actually, it is actually converting one of my other videos also. That's why it is taking some time. You can see the progress over here. Now, as this bar completes, you will get your final video in the folder where you have stored your PowerPoint presentation. So let's wait for some time till this Microsoft finishes converting this PowerPoint to the video. So what I'm doing is I'm pausing a video for the timing. Okay, that progress bar now has disappeared from here. So let's go and check the folder where we have stored the PowerPoint presentation. So now you can see there is a video file over there, how to add audio to PPT. So if you open up, that will be your video where you added the audio to your PowerPoint presentation. So let me close to. So once this is done, the video is available to you. You can upload the video on your drive and share with your students, or upload the video on your YouTube channel and share the link. So that's it. I hope you must have enjoyed this video. If you have any doubts, then please do a Google search. Don't write it back to me. Okay. There is a lot of search options available on Google. Lot of information available. Okay. That is how I'm learning these things. You can also learn them from the videos or the demos available online. Okay. So thank you very much.